What is it?
It's on red ice radio.
You're red ice.
What is it though?
There's a red ice radio video. They put one up.
Oh, somebody else's.
It was about the Jews, so-called Esau.
He was talking about
it. It was like an hour and a half long video of Hollywood movie clips of showing you how Jews are running shit.
It's
from thousands of movies. Yeah, I couldn't finish it. It was disgusting.
Oh, I can see that.
It make you want to fucking puke. It would make you nauseous watching this shit. Just clip after clip after clip after clip.
Check
it out. It's all about how all the actors are all Jews and. Oh, you already got that going? Yeah, watch that video. Get on Red Ice Radio. Watch one of their new videos. It's called Hollywood. Something about Hollywood. You can't miss it. It uploaded like a week or two ago.
That's a good scripture to go start with too. Revelation 3:9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan.
Oh, let me get it.
Go ahead, read it.
This is Revelation 2:9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, and to know that I have loved thee.
So we always gotta remind people, them Jews over there, they're not the real Jews. They were the real Jews. But we gotta read this. This is out of the Jews.
No, we got a website though. Woe unto the wicked. You don't go to the internet?
It's not for her anyway.
Right.
Here you go. Oh yeah. That looked like your girl. She reminded me of your girl off of Where in the World's Carmen San Diego.
Oh, sure.
Everybody going pantless and little shorts and shit.
You remember Where in the World's Carmen San Diego, the TV show?
What was it?
The host. She reminded me of the host.
Oh, yeah.
Here you go. It's what the Jews said out the so-called Jews. They're really Edomites. It says, Edom is modern Jewry. This is from the Jewish Encyclopedia. Was that from 1925? So we ain't making this shit up. It says, strictly speaking, it is incorrect to call an ancient Israelite a Jew or to call a contemporary Jew an Israelite or a Hebrew. They actually are Hebrews, though.
Yeah.
Hebrew Edomites. And that's out of another Jewish almanac compiled by some Jews, some devils.
What are you making anything up?
Right. Here you go. We can go into where these devils come from.
Yeah, go ahead.
The start, the beginning of them. We just basic scriptures right now at the moment.
They come from Mount Seir.
All right, Genesis 25 and 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord for his wife because she was barren. And the Lord was entreated of him, and then Rebekah, his wife, conceived. And the children struggled together within her. And she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire the Lord. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels. And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger. And when her days...
Yeah, so soon in the kingdom of heaven, right now we're on the bottom. In the kingdom of heaven, Esau is going to be on the bottom.
Sitting in pits.
Yeah, you got an apocrypha on you? Your pocket goes back in. Give me as long as you got it. Sure. Give me that's why I tape mines up. Get was that 2 Ezra 6? And what was that? 6:9. Yeah, we'll start off with 7. Did you already read the part where he told me he took his heel? Did you read that part?
Nope,
yet?
I'm going down.
Okay, hold on, just hold that. We'll get in a second.
And I'm start back at 23. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels.
Two manner of people, two totally different types of people.
And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger. And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb. And the first came out red, all over like a hairy garment, and they called his name Esau.
Right, like the so-called Jews, they're the palest people on the planet, aren't they?
Yep.
You'll never see a Jew with freckles. You know, y'all remember that one day you had that dude tell me I wasn't a Jew because I had freckles? They the palest, and a lot of them are hairy too, and they got, some of them have tails.
What's the logic behind that? Because you got freckles.
I don't know, but these freckles are melanin.
I remember that shit too.
There's that dude down there with the bagpipe guy. He was playing bagpipes. And I told him that the Lord only came from the nation of Israel. He asked me what nation I was. I told him I was an Israelite. He said, you ain't no Israelite. All those freckles on your face. Because originally all the Israelites, for the people on the camera, they was all dark-skinned people. In the beginning, all nations were dark.
So my son's not an Israelite? And he got freckles, all the freckles?
Right. I don't know. Some people would say he's a heathen.
Mm-hmm. I guess that'll make me a heathen, dude. Let me read this precept real quick, Deuteronomy 7:6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy power. The Lord thy power hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
So yeah, so Israel's the special people of the Lord. We're the Lord's chosen people. Mm-hmm. Oh, go ahead.
Above all the people that are upon the face of the earth.
Yeah, so we're above all people on the face of the earth.
Okay, 26.
The earth is our birthright. It belongs to us.
The universe.
Yeah, the universe. We're the masters of the universe.
Right. Where'd they come from?
The He-Man?
Yeah.
He-Man.
Masters of the universe. And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment, and they called his name Esau. And after that came his brother out. And his hand took hold on Esau's heel, and his name was called Jacob.
Right, so Jacob came out the womb holding on to Esau's heel. And what that means is that Esau is going to rule the world first, but in the kingdom, we're going to rule, in the kingdom of heaven. The first evil got to reign upon the earth first before the righteousness. You know what I mean? That's the way the Lord has set it up. We got proof of that in 2 Ezra. It breaks that scripture down.
This goes with it too. What we were just talking about before we got here. Job 9:24.
Oh, yeah.
The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covers the faces of the judges thereof.
Right, yeah, like the so-called Jews over there in Israel, they cover the faces of the judges, because the judges are Israel. And they claim that they're Israelites. When they share no traits of the ancient Israelites, you know what I'm saying? They're not the mighty warriors. You read the Bible tells you that the Israelites were mighty warriors. King David had killed tens of thousands, you know, with his hands. With his hands, with a sword. You know what I'm saying? Joshua had killed thousands. Saul had killed thousands. I mean, just the mightiest warriors on the earth, gifted with superhuman physical abilities. But those Jews over there in Israel, they have no kind of physical abilities. You know what I'm saying? They can't play sports. They're uncoordinated.
Can't sing.
They can't sing. Right. King David is known for being the greatest musician ever, playing that harp, which is pretty much the same thing as a guitar. So who's the greatest guitar player of all time? Who? Jimi Hendrix. It's not a fucking Jew, a so-called Jew, I can guarantee it. So that's how we know who the Israelites are, through the traits. All you gotta do is just line them up.
And the Israelites was a mighty man. Okay, cover the face of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
Yeah, you ever see a Jew play a guitar? I had never seen it. Could you imagine such a thing?
Oh, yeah, I see it all the time, them being playing instruments. They're raised on that shit, man. But it's just,
I mean,
it's
garbage.
It's boring, right? There's no life. There's no life in it.
The only so-called Jew I had seen him play a guitar and sound good was one of the Beastie Boys. But they're actually Israelites. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
James.
They just think they're one of them devils. They got scattered among the heathen.
Straight James.
Cause your one boy dude, he was nasty on that bass. What's the dude that passed away? MCA? He had skills on that bass. But he's actually an Israelite. He don't even look like them other Jews, you know what I'm saying? Talk with a deep voice. He don't talk like a faggot like them rabbis. What's that?
17:20. Oh Lord, there is none like thee. Neither is there any God besides thee, according to all that we have heard of our ears. And what one nation in the earth is like thy people Israel, whom God went to redeem to be his own people, to make thee a name of greatness and terribleness by driving out nations from before thee, thy people, whom thou hast redeemed out of Egypt.
Yeah, so Israel is the greatest nation on earth. You know,
he said, what great nation is
it? It's a great nation, right? So what is a nation? Is a giant body of people. Don't you know there's more Israelites on the earth than any other people? You know what I'm saying? We are the most numerous people on the planet earth. And we scattered throughout the four corners of the planet. That's why we are here teaching this word, man, to wake up Israel. That's, you know what I'm saying? To teach the gospel to all nations. To wake up Israel, who's scattered among these heathens. Get that. Second Ezra 6 is starting 7. Now this going to break down that scripture he read earlier in Genesis.
Second Ezra 6 and 7.
It's going to tell you what that symbolism in Genesis was talking about when, because Esau was born first. Esau's the devil. He, you know, the child of Satan. And he came out first, okay? He came out first. But then Jacob came out holding his heel. And it's going to break down that symbolism. Read that.
2 Ezra 6 and 7. Then answered I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of the times? But when shall be the first? What shall be the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? He said unto me, Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau was born.
When Jacob and Esau were born, keep going.
Of him, Jacob's hand held first the heel of Esau.
Right, Jacob's hand held Esau's heel. Keep going.
For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth.
Yeah, Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that followeth. So right here, this right here is Satan's kingdom, right? This is Esau's kingdom. But the kingdom that follows after this is going to be Jacob's kingdom. You know what I'm saying? The kingdom of Israel. The kingdom of the Most High. Yahweh's kingdom. There ain't going to be no faggot shit. Okay, there ain't gonna be no adultery. Ain't gonna be no barbecue pork chops and no bratwurst. Ain't nobody eat no swine's flesh. There ain't gonna be 7-day work weeks. Okay? Ain't gonna be none of this filth in the kingdom.
Right, what you got? Yeah, I'm just trying to find this
scripture. Right, because this is Esau's kingdom. Like we was just before we started filming, we was talking, hold on a second. We's talking about Prince Harry. Prince Harry, he's a goddamn Edomite. All right, he's one of Esau's people. And what he loves his king. This is his kingdom. Okay, his family's running shit. Him and the so-called Jews. And he's over there having fun, flying around in his helicopter, blowing little children up.
Yeah, if he's not raping them.
He's raping them too. Oh. Yeah, there's all kind of truth coming out about how all the royal family is getting caught with sex slaves. You know what I'm saying? Getting caught molesting children. Just like that dude, Jimmy Savile, he was friends with the royal family. He got exposed. He was raping all kind of little boys. He had little sex dungeons. He had snatched little boys up and raped them. All the royal families, they into that shit. They're raping children, sacrificing them to Satan. Pedophilia is huge over there in the UK. It's huge over here in America too. All the politicians, they all goddamn Edomites. They doing the same thing. They're a bunch of devil worshipers. You know what I'm saying? They're sacrificing children to Satan, chopping their heads off, drinking the blood, sprinkling the blood on each other. They eat the flesh.
That's crazy.
Remember when even Alex Jones brought out that report years ago and how some people got caught smuggling chocolate covered roasted babies wrapped in gold foil. And it was, you know, that was some high dollar shit. But they got caught shipping them in.
They probably gutted them just like they do cattle.
Yeah, they probably take the guts out so they don't rot the flesh.
Yeah.
They probably make it look, yeah, jerky. Baby jerky. They do all that, man. Salted baby meat.
That's fucking crazy, man.
Because the scientists came out and said, if you drink baby's blood, if an old person drinks it, it can rejuvenate you, give you energy, and make you feel more young. But you see, a lot of these elite, they've known this for years. A lot of these high priests, okay, these high priests, sorcerers, and warlocks, they've known about this since the ancient Babylonian days. Why do you think they were sacrificing children back in ancient Babylon? Mm. They knew they took that baby and sacrificed and drank the blood, it would make them live longer and then rejuvenate them. So they do the same thing today.
Shit change.
That's where the custom of Easter eggs come from. Back in ancient Babylon, they would sacrifice a baby on top of a ziggurat. And then they would take the eggs and dip it in baby's blood. Mm. You know, then they would eat it, you know what I mean? Mm. Got some colored eggs. So that's where the tradition of coloring eggs goes back. And that's why they always have children going on the Easter egg hunt. That goes back to the sacrificing of children. Some douchebags. And you read all through the Bible too. The Bible talks a lot about child sacrifice. So it's definitely going on. You can't say we're crazy. You're just making that shit up. People have been doing that for thousands of years. There's a reason why there's laws in the Bible that said don't sacrifice your children to Molech. I should get a scripture to back that up.
I got this Lamentations 4:21. All right. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom, that dwelleth in the land of Uz. The cup also shall pass through unto thee. Thou shalt be drunken and shall make thyself naked.
Yeah, that cup is that cup of slavery. The Esau has enslaved the nation of Israel. Enslaved and murdered. They done fucked us up. So they gonna drink out of that same cup. That's why in the kingdom, all the elites of the earth, the rulers of the earth, they gonna go into slavery. We gonna put them in chains. We ain't gonna kill them. We're not gonna kill them. We're gonna put them in chains.
The punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished, O daughter of Zion. He will no more carry thee away into captivity. He will visit thine iniquities. O daughter of Edom, he will discover thy sins.
Right. The Lord got the Lord done discovered their sins. Now we out here exposing it. You know what I mean? The Lord done put the spirit on us. Come out here and teach people about all this evil shit that's going on. So you gotta warn the people.
Whether they like it or not. Yet, this is Joel 2:19. Yea, the Lord will answer and say unto his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil, and ye shall be satisfied therewith, and I will make no more, and will no more make you a reproach among the heathen.
You should stomp on the devil.
Don't believe in the Bible? No. You believe in God?
No.
Why am I not surprised?
Yeah, we are atheists.
I don't know.
You don't know?
Do we look non-godly?
Yeah.
Oh, no, but how so?
How? The way you dress?
Yeah, your whole countenance bears
sickness.
Wearing
pajamas.
A woman ain't supposed to wear that pertaining to a man. Pants.
Yeah, a woman's supposed to wear a dress.
I'm not a woman.
You know?
You're a dude?
No, I'm neither.
You're a transgender.
You're a Pat. You don't know who Pat is?
What?
Pat. You don't know who Pat is? Oh, that's before your time.
Oh, the SNL thing?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You're a Pat?
Well, no.
The world. You know anything.
Yeah, no point.
What?
It's just gonna be a rude awakening.
So y'all eat pork, I know for sure, don't you?
Yeah.
You love swine's flesh,
oh,
don't
you? Oh, you a couple guys, a couple.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's pretty scary. Hey, you know, we got scriptures for that. Hey, get that Romans.
Romans 1.
Romans 1, yeah.
Yeah, they do it, like, all the time.
What?
Yeah, there's a huge argument, like,
community
about,
he's already got it.
What?
Yeah,
like,
get that Roman
book. This is one of the
women. What's up, homie?
Brothers.
Hey, we got a scripture for you.
Yeah, sort this.
Yeah, but I'm
get up close, read it. Read aloud, just read it. Listen up.
Romans 1 and 25. Who changed the truth of God into a lie? Where shall we serve the preacher more than the creator? Who is blessed forever? Amen.
So you were born the way you are. You just professionalized your choice.
Right.
Either you were adopted from some Edomites and they, you know, mentally changed you the way you are, you guys are. But the way you are is just a total abomination. It's totally against the
You're like heathens. You're likened unto a heathen.
It's totally against God. Totally. Well, that's why you don't believe, because you taught that God is an enemy of lesbians and homosexuals. Because he is. So they teach you that, oh, the Lord don't exist. You know?
That's how they justify their wickedness. They justify the wickedness by saying, there's no God.
Right, right.
Read this. This is what the Bible says.
For this cause God gave them up into foul affections.
Into vile affections. Being a homosexual is a vile affection. Man, whether being homos or lesbians. So read that again.
For this cause God gave them up into foul affections. For even their woman did change the natural use into that which is against nature.
And likewise, the woman changed the use.
Yeah, keep going.
Likewise, also the men, leaving the natural use of a woman, burning their lust one towards another, men with men working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves the recompense of their error, which was me.
You don't care.
Saying, if you don't change your ways, you're going to pretty much get slaughtered. It ain't going to be a kind death. It ain't going to be a quick...
it's going to be torturous.
You're right. It's going to be a torturous death.
It's going.
That's where the world's heading to right now. It ain't the way the world is changing. It's changing in the face of the people, but the people don't see it. American people, don't they refer to American people as stupid, the rest of the world?
They dumb as hell.
You know, when there's shit going on right now, but the only American people acting like everything is fine and dandy, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, obviously.
But we out here paving the way for the Lord. And like I said, if y'all don't change your ways, like I said, it's going to be a gruesome death.
It's going to be a wrap.
It's going to be a gruesome death.
So
huh?
Your God is morally reprehensible. I'm sorry. So I can't take it seriously.
You might not be a Jack anyway.
But it does. You know, the truth does not require you to believe. So what you think is irrelevant.
Okay. Oh, what you call me? Like, what you say that for? What you say they ain't eating right?
Might be. You need a mic? That's a nation of people.
Satan.
See, we're Israelites.
Esau.
We're not niggas. We're not Negroes.
Okay.
Or Irishmen. Scottishmen. We're none of that.
Okay.
We're Israelites.
You identify as Israelites.
Huh? What's that?
You identify as Israelites.
Right.
Okay.
You're Israelite. You see the sign there. Okay. See, Israel don't know we're Israelites. That's part of the curses we under.
Okay.
We don't know we're Israelites. But that's why we're out here. We're out here to teach Israelites. We're not out here to teach every nation. We don't give a damn about the rest of the nation.
We're not out here to teach women at all, actually, period. Because women, the truth ain't really for a woman anyway.
Right.
Y'all just gonna do what you do anyway. You gonna walk around, you gonna be a heathen, and you just gonna just be wicked as could be.
Some women ain't humble though.
There ain't no humble women. There's like two of them.
Two.
You know what I'm saying? It's like two or three.
Turn that into a percent.
You can count them on one. Well, the scriptures say.
That's a fraction of a percent.
Well, Solomon said. Actually, if it's a percentage, Solomon said out of 1,000 women, he cannot find one righteous woman.
Here you go. Yeah, I'm about to get
so,
that.
So if it's in a percentage, it's going to be like 0.009.
Right.
We're just keeping it real.
It's going to be a tiny fraction.
How many women was at the Last Supper?
You know what? They said there was only one.
Who?
That's what they said. That's what
Mary and Mary
Esau
Magdalene.
Said, yeah.
Mary,
Esau
was.
Said, they said, Jesus fucked Mary Magdalene.
That's what they tried to say.
Check this out. Here you go. Please ask the 7.
He ain't have sex with nobody.
Please ask the 7:26. And I find more bitter than death the woman, whose heart is snares and nets, and her hands as bands. Whoso pleaseth the Most High shall escape from her, but the sinner shall be taken by her. Behold, this have I found, said the preacher, counting one by one to find out the account, which yet my soul seeketh. But I find not one, but I find not one man among 1,000 have I found, but a woman among all those have I not found.
So he said among 1,000 men, he only found one righteous man.
One.
So, I mean, you got some cool women out there, you know what I mean, but... We ain't out here for women, man. We out here to teach men.
Men is the only ones that's gonna wake us up.
Yeah,
men.
The men's the only one waking up. They're the only ones who care about truth.
So y'all students here at OSU, y'all ain't student all. Y'all just down here chilling. Because this is a place to be for homosexuals and lesbians.
Yep.
It's the place to be further down that
oh,
way.
Oh, yeah, sure. Right. Live
she said, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know about that.
You know, I rode by here the other day, man. What was that, Saturday? I was, you know, just getting some air, just peeping out shit.
Right.
And, man, I was coming down the main part where everybody, all the shoppers are, and that's all I seen was male homosexual couples. I barely seen any lesbians, though, but I'm sure they was out there. But I was seeing them kissing and everything, man.
It's nasty, man.
I was seeing them kissing out in the open when back in the day, you know, their spirit, because that's how you know it's wrong. Because back in the day, they used to hide it. Because it's their spirit saying it's wrong. So they was hiding it. But back in the day, they used to hide it because we used to smash them down. We used to beat fags down.
The Bible says you're supposed to
smash them. You're supposed to put up their ass.
Oh, yeah.
Fags. A man sticking his rod up another man's ass.
That's nasty.
Come on, think about it.
Getting dookie all over themselves.
That's what shit comes out of.
Angel sex is awesome.
She said she don't know what's wrong with me.
You know your thing.
So you enjoy playing.
Don't you know how unhealthy that is?
Hey, let's get the sign. Hold this.
Get the scripture.
You know how unhealthy? You ain't supposed to stick a woman in your ass.
Let's read the sign. Let's get to the facts.
Yeah, they're wrong.
Look, there's over 110 million cases of STDs in America.
Yeah. Condoms and dental dams are super cool.
Well, condoms.
Why is there so many?
Condoms causes infections themselves.
They put AIDS in the condoms when they package them up and wrap them
that's
up.
That's right. That's right.
Okay, because only a man's not supposed to wear a condom.
Do you have any evidence of that?
Oh, come on, it's medical. It's all kind of medical.
It's been proven many times.
This is CDC. Okay.
Where?
You don't know. Center of Disease Control.
Not that.
What you talking about? Unhealthy living, about homosexual living?
No, if you stop it, I'm going to tell you.
Go ahead.
I was referring to this particular claim that they put AIDS in condoms.
Oh, they do this. There's been cases and reports of it.
Yeah. Where?
Where?
Look up on the internet. Google that shit.
Yeah. Google.
Yeah, you got phones. Ain't no
damn
excuse.
Got the world in your hand.
Got the world in your hand. The world wide web. That's what they call it, right?
So what is this? That's what they call
it. Israelites. Israelites. You're an Israelite. You're not a nigga, are you? You a nigga? You're an African American? So you, your ancestors come through the line of Ham, the Hamites, the so-called Africans? They do?
My ancestors came from Africa?
Let me show you something real quick.
Please don't. Down to you now, brother.
Let's get down a little bit, bro.
You about to break it down now, bro.
Let me show you something.
Because you don't know how to search.
You ever heard of Zonovan Bible Dictionary?
Bible Dictionary.
Yeah.
What should we search instead?
Figure it out. If you want to find the truth, you'll find it. I'm not overly concerned with
women,
you.
Women, that's what being a feminist is. Being a non-believer, that's what being a feminist is.
Okay.
That's what women are. Ain't no women the real true believers. That's why none of the apostles of the Lord are women.
None of them.
Anyway, hold on. Let me just read this for you, brother.
Sorry, but again.
That's packed, bro.
Not that either. But.
What book is that, brother?
It's Bible Dictionary.
Oh, okay.
That looks like a book from the ancient world.
Right.
This is the first print.
That's a nice one, man.
It's the original print.
That's like for the 50s or something?
I gave Durrell my original, the one I bought, the new one.
That's pretty sweet.
It's old, ain't it? This is a definition of ham. See, you notice ham ain't on here anywhere. And plus, when you give me Revelation 7.
The Egyptians were Hamites.
What you got, sir?
You know the ancient Egyptians? You believe in the Bible?
Who?
What does the Bible say about ancient Egypt? They was wicked and evil. The Lord delivered Israel out of the hands of the Pharaoh. Because the Pharaoh was oppressing them and had them in slavery.
That's right. This is Ham. The youngest son of Noah. You know about Noah? Noah has three sons. The youngest son of Noah, born probably about 96 years before the flood. We lived longer back then. And one of eight persons to live through the flood. He became the progenitor of the dark races.
So Ham, what's the progenitor mean? That means the forefather. So this says Ham was a forefather of the dark nations, right? And keep going.
It was Isis.
The Negroes.
Not the Negroes.
So Isis.
The Egyptians.
Ham.
The Ethiopians. Libyans and Canaanites.
So why does it say Ham was a forefather of the dark races, but not the Negroes? Why did it say that? And that's a white man wrote that book.
That's right.
Words.
So why did he say that? And notice he didn't elaborate on it too much either.
Right.
It threw you a little kernel of truth.
That's a bad scripture, too. That's a bad one.
Let me hear it.
Go ahead.
Exodus 11:7. But against any of the children of Israel shall not a dog move his tongue against a man or beast, that ye may know that the Lord doth put a difference between the Egyptians and Israel.
That's right. There's a total difference
between
the 12 tribes and those nasty-ass Africans. Those nasty, foul-ass Africans.
Right, because the modern-day...
We're totally different people.
The modern-day Egyptians would be like
the
Sudanese...
Oh,
what's up, homie?
Hey, y'all.
What's up, Al?
The modern-day Egyptians would be like the Sudanese people. They don't look nothing like so-called Negroes in America.
I got a picture.
Just like an Ethiopian. You ever? I got a better example. What about a Somalian? They dark-skinned, right? Is that your people? A Somalian?
I mean, at the end of the day, they're my people.
Oh, hell
no. When you go around them now.
Black, right?
So what?
No, just because you got brown skin don't make you the same nation.
So what if you had a whole family of Somalians move next door to you?
When was the last time?
Stinking up the place.
I'd be more pissed off if the whole people look like your color, and you right next to me.
Well,
I don't
know
really
what,
care what you
listen, bro. Listen, bro. Everybody ain't every white nation is not the same nation.
How you gonna point that to the black nation?
See, every black nation ain't the same nation.
Go to the book with it.
Okay, I'm gonna go to the book. Go get a scatter scripture.
I got a scripture.
Go ahead.
Listen, bro. Cause listen. We're being punished by the Heavenly Father, Bahashim Yahawashah. We're being punished because we broke his laws and his commandments, being faggots, eating pork, committing adultery, which is a sin worthy to get your head chopped off. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So we breaking the Lord's laws. So he said, okay, I delivered y'all this many times, that many times, delivered y'all out of Egypt, you know, but y'all still kept going against me. So he said, okay, I'm going to punish y'all this time, and I'm going to put y'all in captivity under these Edomites, the so-called white man. But at the same time, he scattered us among all them other nations. That's part of our punishment, living around heathens.
Let me get that scripture to back you up.
People that eat shit. Because this is a common thing with these other nations. They eat shit. Literally, eat shit.
These
nations are living amongst those other nations, living like heathens. So when the Bible mentioned Gentiles... Oh, go ahead. What you got, bro?
That's scripture that you was pretty much breaking down.
Okay.
This is Daniel 9:7. O Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee, but unto us confusion of faces.
Here we go. Confusion of faces.
As
unto us. Now, who is he talking to? Israelites. So he's saying to us, we have confusion of faces. So people ain't being spiritual. You judging shit by its cover. You understand what I'm saying? So. That's why these, for example, these two brothers. I ain't calling you a nigga, but these are niggas. The black men. These are black men, but these are part of the curses, leprosy of some of us. Like some of us got curses. We get jobs, we can't keep it, can't save money, gotta pay these bills, child support.
You really gotta talk to people though?
Huh?
You don't think that kind of behavior is talk to somebody?
What you mean talk?
To not be a man? You don't think that...
I mean, that's part of the curses. Been educated into some other bullshit.
When does it come upon yourself to say, I'm a man and produce for yourself?
Mm. Oh, man. Look.
Because now we can finish the scripture. Go ahead, brother, because let's talk about it.
Let me finish the scripture here. Daniel 9:7, we'll start from the top. O Lord, righteousness belongeth unto thee, but unto us confusion of faces, as it this day to the men of Judah, and to the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and unto all Israel that are near and that are far off through all the countries whither they has driven them, because of their trespass that they have trespassed against thee.
That's a beautiful scripture,
bro. O Lord, to us belongeth confusion of face, to our kings, to our princes, and to our fathers, because we have sinned against thee.
See, we're kings and princes, okay? But now, like the scripture says, the prophet saw princes walking, and he saw servants among horses. Like you see these cops riding horses. They're really servants. They are slaves. They are slaves. You know what I'm saying? What was y'all getting wrong?
I got a scripture for you. Get that Leviticus 13:13. He's getting it. I got a scripture for you.
I'm going to show you the picture of the real Egyptians.
Amos 9:9. For lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel from among all nations.
Ooh.
Like as corn is sifted in a sieve.
Sift amongst all nations. You know about sifting?
Like what you do with rice.
Rice.
You
you're separating the dirt.
Yeah.
You're sifting. So the Lord is sifting.
Gold. You were getting gold.
Right. Yeah. So the Lord is sifting.
Well, Israel's liking under gold. You know what I'm saying? Because the scripture said we're going to be tried as gold in the fire.
That's right.
Because when you get that gold in the fire, you got to put in the fire to take out all those impurities out of that gold.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right. That's part of the process of digging gold out the ground. Right?
Let me read this.
And before you burn it, it's being sifted. Right, my bad.
Oh, you? It's good. For lo, I'll command to sift the house of Israel from among all nations, like as a corn is sifted in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth.
Mm.
Now, I'm going to get another scripture, too. Read that Leviticus 13:13. You know about the law? You ever read the laws in Leviticus? You ever hear about leprosy? Some people might call me a leprous dog, crack-ass cracker. You know what I'm saying? They say that, right? But you read the book of Leviticus, and it tells you about the laws of leprosy. And it tells you the Israelites, who were dark-skinned people, were cursed with the plague of leprosy. So read that.
Curses.
Leviticus 13:13. Then the priest shall consider, and behold, if the leprosy have covered all his flesh, he shall pronounce him clean that hath the plague. And it is all,
read it again from the top.
Then the priest shall consider, and behold, if the leprosy have covered all his flesh,
covered all his flesh from the top to the bottom, keep going.
He shall pronounce him clean that hath the plague. It is all turned white. He is clean.
Mm.
So that was a curse, because the law, the book in Leviticus, was only given to the Israelites.
Did I just say when you're white, you're clean?
No, well, you got two
clean
different. You got different forms of leprosy. You got actual leprosy where your fingers be falling off. You get the sores and the lesions.
You get the other one where you get to live in the suburbs and go to nice schools.
Well, that's something different.
You ever been to a house?
I don't live in no suburbs.
I'm not really just talking to you.
So do your spirit and his spirit the same? You can see y'all, totally different nation of people.
What's that?
Ain't that a little bit dangerous to say that because they have darker skin color, that they're not our brothers and sisters?
See, they're not, they got pushed,
they
got
pushed darker color
west.
West what are, into
what, is that, Sudan? Is that the message we want to be pushing today?
Right.
Is that because they're darker than us?
Because
you got some of us that are dark like that. I got a daughter that's dark like that.
Because the people in Egypt are the Persians, right?
It ain't really about
them on that side right there.
Right now.
It's about
right
the spirit.
Those are not my people right there. Although their skin looks like mine.
I don't even know these people. You know what I mean?
I don't even know. Those are Satan. That's Satan.
They do the stuff that the policies they put on. I don't know if they're people.
No, them.
Hey, I know the people they put in front of us.
They're a race of devils.
They got devilish actions.
Yeah, you
but,
ain't.
You know, for the people that they're promoting, that they're doing all this devilish stuff for, they're benefiting. Now, from people of my color or people of your situation,
they call us all Goyim.
Goyim?
Goyim.
Is that what they
cattle.
Call
cattle.
They call all any not, because they're not in Jews. Those are Edomites.
Yeah.
They're not. They're liars. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, these are Jews mixed in with politicians, right?
Yeah. No, all the politicians are Jews. All those
even
are
Obama's
actual,
a Jew.
He's a Hamite. He's not a Negro. He's a Hamite.
Obama's not on there.
His dad's.
Oh, okay, yeah, but
he's an actual Hamite. He's not a so-called Negro.
No, but
did you see him play basketball? Did you see him when he was playing basketball?
That nigga sucked. He got a cool shot.
Come on, bro. Let's keep it real.
Oh, I've never seen him play. I've never seen him.
He spent more hours in the library than some others.
There you go. Because
that's why you ain't never seen him.
He just ain't got that swagger like a brother.
Because that's what Hedomites do. They read. But the Negroes, we play ball. Brother, you're losing me on this message. Come on, man.
It's true, though.
I mean, hey, a big chunk of Negroes is all worrying about basketball and football.
See, now, we was just talking about this.
Yeah, it's a problem.
It is a problem.
But like, it's a curse.
It's like in my neighborhood.
When the Lord changes.
But you see,
but first of all,
one woman
that's why we're out here.
She went to college.
Yeah.
That's where the change starts.
When we talked about Martin Luther King,
that's where it starts at, right here. It starts in the mind first until the Lord come physically change.
When they talking about the basketball thing, because Israel was
the big booty bitches that we talked about. They got the gold chain,
the ability of music.
So we see that, and that's what we
exactly.
Anybody like Tupac coming out of Africa?
For something strong.
You ain't never gonna see that. You ain't never seen no Jimi Hendrix coming out of Africa.
Okay, gets hot.
He's the greatest guitar player ever. You know what I'm saying?
We're not like, yeah, I want to send us for something to get killed for.
That was the whole setup.
We want the gold on the back and the diamond in the
air. That's just, the music, only a spiritual, only an Israelite can make that type of music.
And they glorify that,
appearing
on TV.
It changes
you
just
do.
Because there's some shit you got to do if you want to get to that high level. You know what I mean? You got to defile yourself. You got to do all types of things. They don't tell you that. They just tell you, work hard, go to school.
That's why us.
And you can accomplish.
witnesses suing Jesus, but they ain't so you telling you what's behind the scenes.
We are still there.
You got Israelites look like Chinese people, like Bruce Lee.
I got another script.
It's all about the spirit. You can look into their eyes, look into their spirit.
So these two can be of the same spirit.
No.
Y'all bring your head back. That was you.
She said she's neither a man nor a woman.
We got roll. Transgender.
Hey man, let me get this scripture for you real quick.
We out here every Thursday.
This is Tobit 13:3. Confess him before the Gentiles, ye children of Israel, for he have scattered us among them.
Right, so we got to teach this gospel to all nations, because the Lord has scattered Israel among all nations.
Okay. Well, there's not that many
one more
of
you,
and that's
no,
why
no, actually, Israel is the most numerous people on the planet.
I'm talking about people like you. Sir.
No, they big. Chicago, man. They big out there.
Yeah.
They everywhere. Go on YouTube and watch them. They making noise.
Yeah, we're the same brothers.
Yeah, they making noise.
That's all, bro. Yeah. Oh, check this out. The one more scripture. This is Romans 8, and I'm sorry, 13. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of the Most High, they are the sons of the Most High.
Because it's a simple thing to judge someone by the flesh. That's how a child would think.
I don't think it would do that.
You know what I'm saying? That's a real simple, low level.
It is.
Yeah. You got to be spiritual. Everything's about spirit.
All about the spirit. It's a spiritual battle, bro.
Appreciate it.
All right, brother. Y'all take it easy.
Hey, if y'all was on Twitter, you can look yourself up. Kings of the Earth.
All right.
Y'all about to make out
or something?
Y'all
ain't trying to run on us.
Y'all
can hang out with us. What's the problem?
Well, I mean, circumcision is also a serious problem. Things that have not happened, but this is not.
Sucking on baby dicks is the problem.
That's
a big ass problem.
We are uncircumcised and unclean.
But this is okay. Well, now you're just back in the same problem. But this was the only sort of redeemable part of anything going on here.
Yeah,
the spreading education about the fact that this happened. That's not a lie. I've seen it.
You happened. That's spreading education.
So, like, you know, that's a problem. So is everything else.
Y'all are.
I'm a little confused with this Voltaire quote. Yeah,
man.
I like that.
Nice.
I mean, that's
drugs,
okay.
Bro. This is who Esau gonna have.
Voltaire
can sweet love, huh?
Voltaire
can sweet love. You know, that's Esau. You know?
Excuse me?
Oh, I'm trying to rapping with the brothers.
Okay.
I'm just rapping with the brothers. Oh, yeah. Check y'all. Before y'all put y'all, you know, y'all might like this one too.
Okay.
Y'all might like this one.
Just maybe.
Leviticus 20.
Oh, you got the Edgar Allan Poe shirt. He was a Jew.
What was he?
Now you're going to have to burn your shirt.
Huh. I am actually
It looks like it's already been burned.
Jewish people, by and large, I am actually
we know you are. You like Jewish people. That's why they're not the real Jews. That's why they call themselves Jewish.
Yeah, and we'll say Israelis.
Israelis.
They're rats. They're
roaches. They're roaches.
They're walking gonorrhea. You know? Yeah, they're cancer on the planet Earth.
What's that scripture?
That's why there's wars and chaos going on right now. Because of those.
What's that scripture? The border of all wickedness. I can't.
That's a Malachi.
You know what I'm talking about?
Malachi 1, I'll get it.
Huh? They're not what?
Quite all right. I'm a bit concerned.
Here comes your homies.
About Esau?
Hey, is that your brother? Hey, you got your brother.
Did you call God?
Man, I text him.
Oh.
Like, I ain't gonna. He texted me back one time.
I was
messing with him.
Yeah.
I ain't telling who I was exactly.
Right.
Oh, he got, yeah.
And then once I told him who I was, I ain't getting no feedback.
He'll lock you.
Hell yeah. He's gonna be shaped like a fuck. He's gonna be buff on me.
I'm not worried about him, man.
He's gonna be buff on me.
No, the Most High, I have mercy on that except for Bernie Buff. We more concerned with the elites. They going to slave.
The Harold.
Yeah.
Them little raggedy ass Edomites, they just gonna be.
Yeah, because these white people you see,
they just
ain't
gonna
make it. They're not gonna make it.
The majority of them, nope.
They'll be slaves.
Right. Most of our slaves, well, majority, actually, all of them right now is those, the ruling classes over there in the UK and Switzerland.
Switzerland.
You know? all over there, man. Whatever ones are still in Russia.
I got that scripture you was talking about. Malachi chapter 1.
Malachi.
1. The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother, saith the Lord? Yet I loved Jacob, and I hated Esau.
He hates the so-called.
And laid his mountains and heritage waste.
That's who he is. Sure Esau, that's his biblical name. Esau or Edom.
Read this. Read that right there. It says that the so-called Jew, he admits that they're Edomites.
Okay.
Yeah, they know it. They know it.
Let me read. Finish this up.
Rothschild, Red Shield.
Yeah, Red Shield. And I hated Esau, laid his mountains and laid his heritage waste for the dragons of the wilderness. Whereas Edom saith, we are impoverished, but we will return and build the desolate places. Thus saith the Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts means Lord of armies. They shall build, but I will throw down. And they shall call them the border of wickedness, the people against whom the Lord hath indignation forever.
What? Forever?
That's what he's talking about, the border of wickedness.
Forever? Yeah. Don't you know, it's the so-called devil, these Edomites, that's going to cause this destruction. But their thing in their mind is, after destruction comes, after all the smoke settles, after the fire let out, they think they're going to be able to come up out of those caves, up out of the space station,
have deep underground,
and build again.
Get on Google, dumbs. Okay, deep underground military bases.
Post-apocalyptic society, got it.
You said there's what?
There's apparently no such thing as a potential post-apocalyptic society.
So everything's going to be as it is, right?
So everything's going to be like as this, right?
What does the word apocalypse mean? The word apocalypse means to reveal that which is hidden.
Here we go. Psalms 49.
Revelation means the same thing, to reveal.
Right. So, let me get this point, scripture real quick. You see the colloquial sense mean, like, we were this.
But they don't believe in the Bible anyway.
Post-apocalyptic means after those prophecies become fulfilled. Yeah. And then we're going to reign on the earth. And we're gonna rule with a rod of iron. Woo-hoo-hoo. And we're gonna break heathens to pieces.
Man, that sounds
and
so
we're gonna
lovely.
Rule with an iron fist.
Man, that sounds so lovely hearing it.
Let me get this out. Psalms 49 and 11.
That's where I was. That's a spirit.
Your inward thought.
Listen to this.
Psalms 49 and 11. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever, and their dwelling places to all generations. They call their lands after their own names.
Columbus.
Right. Keep going. There's more to it. Yeah, because everybody thinks in their mind that America is going to continue forever and ever.
Right.
This country is not sustainable, okay?
No.
It's going to be destroyed.
No.
It's a cesspool of filth. It's like he said, it's a puddle of diarrhea. You know what I'm saying? Is what it is.
That's right.
Like he said, it's a puddle of diarrhea and syphilis with flies buzzing on it.
That's right, yeah. Maggots.
You know, maggots.
Right. And the people are the maggots.
This is the filthiest place on the planet.
It's like America's like that pig, that roasted pig with the apple in his mouth.
Right.
Laid down on the table.
You ain't lying. Here you go, Daniel 7:18.
It is like liking unto swine's flesh.
That's right. Daniel 7:18. But the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom.
Take the kingdom.
And possess the kingdom forever. Even forever and ever.
Even forever and what does that mean? Forever and ever. Forever ever.
And that's where this world is going. It's not this world ain't gonna be like this much longer.
Okay.
It ain't gonna be much like this much
Things
longer.
Things are ever changing. I can believe it.
You know, right.
I mean, you should learn from history. What happened to the Roman Empire? They was living in decadence. Everybody was faggots. They was eating and pleasuring themselves, having a good old time. It got destroyed.
Babylon, Sodom, and Gomorrah.
Empire was that Egypt. It got too big to sustain itself from.
That's
part of the
problem. That's true too.
Same thing with America.
There you go, America.
You can see history is repeating itself.
How much they spend on their military every year?
Yeah, it was very part of the problem.
Like damn near $1 trillion.
What was it?
America's military budget
is really something.
It's like 800 something billion. But really, if you consider the black. Ops
it's
behind us, the covert motherfuckers. There you go. So it's over $1 trillion.
Exactly about that. But yeah,
they got so much military shit. They giving it to the police station.
Man, over in Yemen, over $500 million worth of military equipment just came up missing.
But they just give
it. They doing that shit on purpose.
They doing it. They giving it to
the ISIS.
America's funding ISIS. Y'all know America funds ISIS, right? Plus, this country's gonna be destroyed. They keep,
you know, they changed it. You know, ISIS had a, well, the original word of ISIS, it was a government site. And it was ISIS.
Yeah, I seen that.
ISIS thing. It was a, turned it to
SIS. It was a special forces. For, it was actually like a, it's like mercenaries.
Mm-hmm. Right, like the ones that's over there in Ukraine.
Yeah,
right now.
I had a favorite
what
one.
What you call them, Blackwater?
Yeah, like Blackwater. Okay. Yeah. Something kind of like that. Special forces motherfuckers.
That's all it is. That's all it is.
Yeah, because ISIS was started by some special forces.
Yes, take your abominable presence from our vicinity.
Okay. We're going to do something like that, really. She's trying to provoke us. To stop kissing, because it's not right for them to be kissing. They need to turn on to something then.
Still not a woman.
I don't know how it is.
You know?
Sweetheart, I understand that it's confusing, but
it's
not a woman.
You're a man.
You're
a and we do not use that word to refer to humans.
But you ain't got a dick in a pussy.
You're like Baphomet.
Well, dude, you got a dick in a
pussy. That's Big Boppy right there.
We don't have to throw out straight genitals.
So you put it on Front Street, though.
My gender is up for discussion. Sure, we can talk about that.
It's up for discussion.
That's okay.
That's so cute. That's so cute. That's cute. It's going to get you killed.
Hate crimes are truly however, don't ask about a stranger's genitals, man.
You're the one kissing in front of
you. You're a woman. You're a female.
Okay, don't ask a woman about their genitals.
You're kissing in front of
you. I just said you're transgender.
Do you believe in being born young?
So God made a mistake.
I feel like there's kind of a combination.
Yes,
obviously
everything is a combination between
nature
like,
and nurture and all that good stuff. So
genetics and environment interact in different ways.
It's certainly
be gone.
You know the thing with you laughing? They love eating each other's ass. So.
Yeah, it gets real nasty.
Yeah. It gets, they get down, bro.
Scary.
We don't ask people about their genitals because that's frankly rude.
Well, kissing in front of us is rude. That's okay. Disgusting. Woman kissing a woman?
Right, what if I had my daughter with me?
Yeah.
Right.
Great. Fantastic, your daughter could be a nice
yeah, because homosexuals are also pedophiles.
Well, my son, I saw this.
So you're teaching my daughter confusion?
I would like your daughter to know that it's okay to be gay.
It is not okay.
Oh, okay.
Says
who?
Says
who?
Says
who? Your own opinion?
Yeah, that's fine.
Says Satan.
All right.
That's pedophilia.
I'm right, but
no. Pedophilia. Well, pedophilia is itself is cool. Acting upon pedophilia.
See, the morals is gone.
His morals is gone.
That's Esau, man.
Yeah,
you gotta realize that. That's Esau.
Sometimes people
no
have
morals,
feelings,
man.
But
before a nation is destroyed,
your feelings don't
matter. So
yeah, pedophilia is cool.
Before actual physical destruction.
I know to keep my daughter away from y'all.
Is the problem. Yeah, in the first place is just something
being queer and being a pedophile help different things.
Yeah. No, it's not.
Awesome.
How's it different?
Words have definitions. I'm sorry.
You goddamn devil be quick.
Like, being goddamn queer in this context meant like, you know, being a lesbian or being a gay man.
You have no argument over here.
That's, you know, that attraction thing.
Attraction. Adult individuals of the same sex.
I got there's a scripture that you may like here.
Don't walk by a building. Don't be surprised a big ass chunk fall off that building. Yeah. Smash both of y'all.
Here we go. This is
don't be surprised if a semi truck
scripture real quick
comes out of control and runs y'all the fuck over.
Or a Coda bus comes up on the curb and runs y'all over.
Romans real quick. Romans 1:26. This is Romans 1:26. For this cause, God gave them up unto vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature.
So that's against nature. There's nothing scientific about a woman being with a woman. Your reproductive organs have a purpose. That's to reproduce.
Why do they happen in so many species if they're against nature?
Because you're talking about
that's against nature. Okay.
Okay, but
what are
yeah.
So what? Since you're so scientific, what is a reproductive? Let me ask you a question. What is a what is a reproductive organ made for? What does it do? It reproduces.
That's
a
right.
Woman, a woman cannot make a child.
Okay, that's completely true.
So that means you have, that means you're retarded.
No,
that's what it means.
Not use ableist slurs. That's
retarded.
It's also not implying that people who have learning disabilities are bad.
Reproductive organs are not
bad.
When was the last time y'all been with a man, either one of y'all?
Yes, actually, that's exactly what it's for.
No, it's not. Like, for example, the clitoris exists.
So you're not with
pleasure.
You? Are you bisexual?
There is no.
No.
So you're just straight women now?
One.
Right
now, I'm actually with a non-binary person. But also,
I am not.
But, like,
yeah, it's confusing.
I tried that thing once.
Freaks come out at night.
Sex is not only exists for procreation, it also exists for pleasure. That's a
That's the main, that's always the lustful one another.
Yeah, bowel affection.
It's all about pleasure. It ain't really about anything else.
It just means that they're talking and they're not listening.
Yeah.
That's why oral sex exists.
You see why the Most High gave us laws.
See, but that's nature, though. That's human nature. That's moral laws.
Your moral laws. And that's what the scripture is.
Okay. Moral. So you're immoral. And the woman's immoral.
Why you think there's two genders? All the species, all the bugs, all the animals.
There's actually not. I know that you're confused. Wide spectrum of intersex. I see why you would think that.
How am I confused?
You haven't been like...
I haven't got fucked in my ass or something? I'm supposed to get fucked in my ass in order to understand?
Cross-state simulation is awesome. However, what I was trying to say was that there are not two sexes even. There's like intersex individuals. Intersex, like...
Woo-wee.
If homosexuality was so okay, why are there so many plagues that come with it?
Yeah, how come homosexual males have a higher rate of HIV and STDs than any other demographic?
Oh, there are a lot of different reasons for that.
Yeah, because they're faggots.
It's unsanitary to stick another dick in another man's ass. That's unsanitary.
Yes, doo-doo.
Okay, if you're concerned about that, you should be concerned about E. coli.
Shit dick.
Not anything else.
Wow. What would that supposed to mean?
You better go to hepatitis.
So they're getting their scat.
Different types of we're concerned about you being in our syphilis, vicinity right now. We might catch something.
There are lots of different reasons.
Yeah, they got that new antibiotic.
Right. Lots of different reasons.
Yeah, lots of different reasons.
Hope y'all don't pass that. Nothing off to
lots
us.
Lots of different reasons.
These are all generally medical reasons.
There is no dialogue. It's nothing but mischievous madness.
Well, we don't even like hearing you speak.
Everything you speak is mischievous.
That's why this place got a fucking go, man.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, brother.
It's past due.
Not the only
you ever read X-Men?
There's also like X-X-X.
You ever read X-Men? You know who Mojo is?
Mojo?
That's your girl, you like Mojo.
Oh, the big blob.
He's for the technology.
No, that's not Mojo. Sexual orientation. I was just talking about sex and gender. Those are kind of different things.
That's one of the reasons
people fuck.
Being a homophobic, or I mean a homosexual, they say they got men chromosomes, so they get
some attractions to women.
It's madness.
The view between the relationship between gender and sexuality,
insane.
It's really a complex thing. It's different in all cultures, and we don't really have definitive evidence for anything.
Complex is a euphemism for confusion. You're a confused idiot.
If everybody had this thought process, the human race would be extinct.
It would be extinct.
How?
Because there won't what?
No what permission.
You mean how? Yeah, actually, don't you know homosexuality is part of the eugenics program? Don't you know that? There's a homosexual agenda being pushed by the elite of the earth. Oh. That's why there's high rates of abortion. And that's why there's increased rates of homosexuality, because it's part of the eugenics propaganda program. Do you know what eugenics are?
Yeah.
They're down with it.
So why does Hollywood, these devils, these are the ones behind it. These devils right here. Who owns Hollywood, so-called Jew? Okay, to them you're just a goy. You're cattle. Okay, you're just a piece of nothing.
See, we focus on the big
and they don't want you to reproduce because you're a useless eater. They don't want useless eaters to reproduce. So that's why they teach the doctrine of homosexuality. That's why they teach the doctrine of abortion.
I arrived at homosexuality by myself.
Let me read this. This is from the website All About Love, which was made by homosexuals.
Okay.
And it says, homosexual behavior medically inferior. Even if we ignore the issues of pre-procreation, the evidence shows that homosexual unions is medically inferior to man-woman unions homosexual behavior. Results in numerous health problems to those who practice it, including increase in AIDS, other STDs, colon and rectal cancer, and hepatitis. These are homosexuals that put a study together. Homosexuals.
That sounds like a very large.
Yeah, that's why they got a store down the street called Out of the Closet. You see it?
Yeah, I love that store.
That's why they have a sign on the window that says free HIV test. Yeah. Because they know being a homosexual is deadly, is dangerous. So the faggots done got so many damn cases of AIDS, and the faggots done spread so much AIDS on the earth. Now they got a homosexual store that got to get free AIDS tests.
HIV AMAs are...
It's the same fucking thing. Among faggots.
We could not continue.
What does the word faggot mean?
Slurs. Well, you're using it to mean...
Dyke, faggots.
It's a bundle of sticks that gets burned up.
That is another definition.
Faggots.
Yes. That's what it literally means.
Yeah, because we not say... Like,
they're gonna be burnt in a fire.
It's a burning stick.
Yeah, a burning stick. You know what I'm saying? Fags.
Right. Let me read this.
You really need help.
According to the Center for Disease Control, more than 82% of all known sexual transmitted AIDS cases in 2006 were a result of male-to-male sexual contact. 82%. Moreover, gay and bisexual men account for more than 60% of all syphilis cases.
Of all syphilis cases.
Shortens the lifespan of homosexuals.
Oh, that's a good thing. So... they could be a faggot on it, they're gonna drop dead.
Yeah, syphilis in particular.
They put it on a sandwich, you know what I'm saying? Just like mayonnaise. Put a little syphilis on there, a little gonorrhea. Oh, nothing.
Put syphilis in food?
No, I'm just saying.
Oh, but you know,
she said it's not that bad.
He got caught at working a salad bar in a restaurant. Yeah. He had AIDS and he was spreading his semen.
Was jacking off in it.
No, he wasn't, bro.
And there have been many cases when dudes got caught doing that.
That's why they got homosexual teachers got caught in school jacking off in the kids' lunches.
Yep.
And the kids was eating it.
Video!
All right, yeah.
Now let him go.
Thank God.
All right, Sotomayor.
Hey, that's just all the bites for your ass right there.
That's nasty. Her shirt was all dirty.
I'm gonna cut you.
I'm glad they got the fuck out of our vicinity.
Yeah, man, that's creeping me out, man.
Hope we didn't catch nothing.
Her ass stink.
I back guarantee you that ass stink. She had stains all up on her shirt, dirt.
Bitch probably licking each other's assholes.
Her girlfriend looked like Mojo from the X-Men.
Yeah, that had me cracking up.
Looked like the, what's that one dude, the Blob?
The Blob.
From, you know, what that would, oh yeah, that's the motherfucking the Sisterhood of Evil Mutants.
Yeah, for real.
You know, you got the Brotherhood of Evil Mutants. That's a Sisterhood of Evil Mutants right there.
Amazing.
What do you call the one dudes that live under the ground?
The
Morlocks. Are they the Morlocks? Or yeah, they hang out with the Mole Man.
Yeah,
that look like something that some of the Mole Man's people.
The little motherfuckers.
Yeah, the subterranean creatures.
Tiny motherfuckers.
Yeah. Oh, there's all kind of creatures down there though.
Right.
You got the little ones, the big ones.
You got scripture?
Oh yeah, bring that out.
Okay.
Psalms 8:2-5. They know not, neither they understand. They walk on in darkness. All the foundation of the earth are out of course.
Yeah, that's just way out of course right there. We got faggots walking around.
Sweet love.
We got Pat. Right, so we got Pat and the Blob kissing each other.
Pat the Blob.
Pat and the Blob.
What the
hell? What the fuck was Pat?
And she was licking that fat bitch's pussy.
Yeah.
That's nasty.
Them lifting them layers up.
You gotta lick it up. You gotta
have a
braces to hold the stomach up just to get to the pussy. You know what I'm saying? You gotta put it on a table or something to hold it up.
Maybe dry humping each other.
Yeah.
Scissor. Yeah.
You can't get to the bitch's pussy. She's so fat. You gotta pretend her belly button's the pussy.
Use one of her robes.
Shit,
man. That's trifling, right?
Amazing.
Trifling.
The bitch said anal sex was cool.
She said it was cool, except for the E. coli part.
Here we go.
So they be into that scat sex. You know that fat bitch got some. You know when she take a shit, it's
funky.
Oh, god damn.
Oh, no.
They just look funky as hell.
Yeah,
man.
They were both fat.
Here we go.
It looked like that bitch just got pissed. She got a piss stain on it. Look like she pissed
pistol.
Wiped their ass with their sweater.
This is a toe bitch.
She probably didn't even know that was there, man. She
probably ain't changed her clothes in weeks.
They was doing drugs or something,
you know?
Man.
Yeah, they was fucked up.
Let me get this scripture out real quick. This is toe bitch. 12:10, but they that sin are enemies to their own life.
They're their own worst enemy.
God,
you know what I mean? Well, we ain't worried about them two dumb assholes.
I'm just so fucking glad they're gone. I thought they were never going
to
leave.
I was actually embarrassed to be seen with them. You know what I'm saying? People think that, you know what I'm saying? We was hanging out with them.
She's transgender. I was tripping.
Wow.
That was some bugged out shit, man.
It's amazing. That's hey, all before you know. We got out here, man, we was in Wendy's, man, talking to him.
Yeah,
we I could send us something crazy to talk to. We got our
He got something crazy
always
to talk
always
to.
Get what we asked for, man.
Before then, we was talking to the one dudes.
And the Black Panthers.
Well, no, of course.
Hey, what's up, my bikes? What's up? Hey,
can
come
you
here.
Talk to him?
Come here for a minute, man.
You scared?
Your last name, Lee?
Or Chi?
No, I know it's like almost every Chinese dude's last name is Lee or Wee or
Yi. Ages, man. Do we all teach them to like not talk to niggas?
No, they think we hate them, which
they're
we do,
general,
but.
Though.
Yeah, right, they are. They're real passive.
I've been to Japan and they're real shy.
And they look down on punters anyway, yeah. So like they're too good to talk to anyways.
Yeah.
Fuck them.
But the Chinese teach you that it's superior people of the earth.
That's what they truly think the world
is. You notice the Chinese, they'll come over to this country, immigrate, but they ain't gonna let us immigrate over there.
Oh, hell no.
That's funny, because China's actually helped bringing this new world order in with the quickness.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Because you see,
they're
paying a huge part of the new world order, because you see, what I'm talking about the scriptures, because they paying, you can see some of those European nations are actually trying to union.
We got the United Kingdom, the Bank of England is teaming up with China right now.
Ain't that some shit?
Yeah.
And the part of the scriptures is all those European nations are turning against America.
Yeah.
You know, you see it happening right in my face, man.
And you see China, they got a one-child policy over there. That means if you get your girl pregnant, if you already got a kid, you got to kill it.
No, they changed it to two childs.
No, it's one child.
I thought they said they're allowed to have two now.
No, I didn't see that. There's just a story.
They said a man got to join the military, though.
It may have changed.
I remember one. There's a story in the news like 2 days ago.
I saw that.
They got underground black market for, what they call that, the monogram? What's they call that? The sonograms. Is that what they call it, the sonogram? Mm-hmm. What, when they look inside a woman's baby to see what sex
ultrasound.
The child is.
Ultrasound.
I don't know what this shit's called.
Go ahead, bro. You got it.
But they got, they was having the black market ultrasounds, and they had somebody doing it up in the hood, and they was trying to find out what sex their child was, because if it's a girl, you got to kill it, because they only want sons, and they got too many women.
Killing the females.
But they accidentally killed one of the, a boy child. And they had mentioned the reason they're doing it is because of the one-child policy.
And those are heathen nations. And India's, Pakistan, India, they're doing the same shit. And the Indian, Pakistan's been doing it just as long as Moab been doing it, man. And now, but the Indian, Pakistan, they don't have a limit. I mean, they can have all the kids they want, but all them motherfuckers got to be boys.
Right.
They don't want to produce girls.
They got too many girls already.
You know? How does that sound, too many females? You can never have enough women, can you?
Well, there's already.
They said down in Brazil, the women are 22 to 1.
But that proves you the man's more important.
That's a nice number.
Yeah, that's a beautiful number. That
proves
Brazil
the man
too.
More important.
Well, that proves that the Lord wants you to have more than one woman, too.
Yeah, I'm right. That's all I was just about to say.
That's the Lord's doing. So, and that's over there in Pakistan, India. That's Israelites over there.
There's a lot of Israelites amongst them people.
Don't you know, over in India, or no, it's, India or Pakistan, they got a huge gang, man.
A huge gang.
The motherfuckers just like the Crippin' Bloods.
Yeah,
how they woken up to the truth?
They live in a slum.
How they woke up to the truth?
Who? Over there?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, you get on
I'm
YouTube.
Sure there's some.
You get on YouTube videos and check out the demographics.
I've never seen no Indian person.
They be watching the videos.
Right.
Israelites and
but,
stuff like that.
I mean, don't say you won't, though. Don't say you won't.
Small possibility, though. Because, I mean, I'm just saying,
you might just say it's going to be the two-thirds
because they don't really know.
Well, actually, you're right.
Let me show you something.
A lot of those is the two-thirds.
Let me show you something.
Right.
Right, but
you got some brothers in London, though, that got a... They look like, you know, you got some Negroes and a couple other cats that look like they're from different nationalities.
You got brothers in Germany.
Ain't number two-thirds over there. Check this out. This is Revelation 79. And after this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude which no man could number, of all nations and kindred and people and tongues. So there's some elects amongst those Elamites. And,
yeah, they over there.
Yeah, they over there. A few of them.
Because, well, you can get on YouTube and you can check out the demographics and see where people are watching.
Mm-hmm.
We got a shitload of people watching our videos in the Philippines.
Ours. Watching our video.
I can only check the demographics of our videos.
Right.
But we got people in the Philippines. A lot of people in the Philippines.
A lot of Jacobs over there, too.
Yep, in the Philippines. We got We got people watching videos in the United Emirates Air. What's that? United Arab Emirates.
Right.
Arab or Israel?
Over in Dubai.
Some of them are. Some of them are mixed amongst.
What I'm saying is the word's going out.
Some of them are mixed amongst.
Hey, remember that script guy read the confusion of faces.
We was out here teaching two Arabs one time.
Oh, that was cool as hell.
One was like.
I remember that.
Like, he came into the truth, like, right there.
He almost,
and he started, he was cussing his boy out.
He was cussing his boy out. He said, you're brainwashed.
Right.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, you remember that?
Yeah.
And he was walking away. He was like, talking to his
boy. Yeah, it was that. I told you. Yeah. Yep.
And,
sure what?
And then when we left.
Yeah, on the Run DMC, Shell Toe. I was like,
those videos from rappers in Japan that you sent me, man.
Yeah. Oh, let me show you this.
Well, you already know I play guitar with this dude from Japan.
Right.
This dude is nasty on the guitar.
Kuni or what you call him?
Kunihisa.
Kuni.
Yeah, we call him Kuni. He don't speak a lick of English either.
But he more than likely he a Jake.
Yeah, he gotta be a Jake.
Has to be.
The way he be playing that guitar, bro. I can't play guitar like that. He be on a guitar. I can't do that shit.
Like, this is a perfect example of Israelite scattered among the heathen. These are Japanese, so-called Japanese.
Wu-Tang forever.
I was in Japan. They love Wu-Tang over there.
Is he really popular in Japan? Yeah. He's a local. Yeah. All those motherfucking rappers.
And they hate Jews.
Yep.
Oh, and my dude Cooney, he hates Jews, bro.
That's an Israelite. Yeah, that's Jake.
He be talking shit about that. But that's how we be
saying. You only can tell from that spirit.
Right.
You ever see a straight, these are supposed to be so-called Ammonite, but you see a straight Ammonite, it looked like they got Down syndrome. They look all fucked up. What's an Ammonite?
It's Japanese.
Who these?
I thought they were in the Moab.
Moab Chinese, Ammon Japanese.
Oh, okay.
But you got, you know what I'm saying? Israel scattered, man.
Yeah, that's Israel. That's
hey, what's up with that
And this homie talking about, he got out in this song talking about fuck Babylon.
What the fuck was that?
I see those, South Korea and Japan
and
starting to bicker.
Get on YouTube.
And two U.S. allies.
Because when I first came into the troop,
they starting to bicker against each other now, man.
And look at
South Korea
see,
and
like,
Japan.
Because
I didn't know Japan. Had South Korean oppression too. I didn't know that.
Shit.
I knew China.
Well, during World War II, Japan was fucking them all up.
Right.
But they all hate Japan.
On YouTube, I mean,
they started bickering
around the world.
Japan, everybody hates Japan.
Same spirit.
That's crazy.
It's Japan. Bad motherfuckers. They were bad motherfuckers.
People want to dispute that all the fuck they want, but they were. They
were trying to conquer the earth.
Damn right.
They teamed up with Hitler and them.
A lot of them just think they're just.
They was fucking shit up over there.
Right. And like you said,
that's a Jake.
His sister's two thirds.
Fat ass.
That's a problem.
Playing some Candlestick.
Candlestick? That was my shit.
Yeah.
And they play that on the radio like every hour on the hour.
And everybody know that. America is modern day Babylon. You ain't talking about the Babylon.
We'll take a break from the camera.
They act like niggas, man. So they are niggas.
You know what I'm saying?
That's because they are niggas.
Yeah, because.
Hey, you got a script.
And I'm only saying nigga to sort of identify. I can say Israelites.
Yeah.
I ain't got to say nigga. I'm Israelites. And they act like Israelites. They got the characteristics of an Israelite.
Yep.
The other nations can't fake the funk.
Can't fake it.
Can't fake the funk. The funk. They can't fake it.
Because I realize.
That funk is the spirit, the soul. It's all the same shit.
Can't no heathen even imitate us.
Yeah, but we can imitate them.
Yeah, we can make fun of them. We can do the Chinese voice too.
Right.
You know?
And then we good at imitating.
Just like the scripture said, we good at your people.
We make jokes about the heathens. We good at imitating
them. We clown.
I had a question, but I'm going to let them
read that scripture. Yeah, let's read that
out. Zechariah 2:6. Ho, come forth and flee from the land of the north. Said the Lord, for I have spread you abroad as the four winds of the heaven, says the Lord. Deliver thyself, O Zion, that dwellest with the daughter of Babylon. For thus says the Lord of hosts, after the glory have he sent me unto the nations which bored you. For he that toucheth you touches the apple of his eye.
Yeah, Israel, the apple of the Lord's eye. Ain't gonna bless the heathen with no magnificent abilities.
You got, if you had kids, man, and you walk with your kid and somebody just came out of nowhere and smacked your child, what would that do to your mind?
I probably black out.
You a flip. You are. You a black out. You don't know what you would do.
Right.
Now, how do you think the Most High feel about what they doing to us, man? You know, he referred to as the apple of his eye, man. You know, we're his children. He's the Heavenly Father. So when that destruction comes, it's going to be worthy of their punishment. The fire, the concentration camps, the guillotines. Motherfuckers get poked in the ass with, what you call them things they put on the tough tip of guns with the knives.
That spear thing.
Called, damn, man. I also made a video on that, too.
Huh?
Do you,
talking about the boar?
Nah.
Would you clean the rifle with?
No, it's like when you run out of...
Oh, yeah, bayonet.
Bayonet, there it is.
Yeah, bayonet, yeah.
Poking niggas in the ass with bayonets.
Oh, yeah.
bayonet.
That's when they'd be like...
Well, don't you know, Columbus handed out like 350,000 bayonets. Man. Now, where in the fuck... I didn't know they had that many police officers, so where the rest... Where they going to? 350,000? They handed out 350,000. So there's the military, the fire department, these medics, the police department, SWAT, all the different, military sects. Man, they military up there. They build themselves up like a military, And Columbus is building up at a fast rate. As far as those Humvees and shit, Columbus getting Humvees and all that, man. I saw them driving down 4th Street.
Machine guns on top of them.
One day on my way to camp, I saw them on 4th Street. Ohio State got them big ass armed vehicles. What the fuck is this university? Yeah.
Wow. Dudes on my that guitar talking trash about Metallica, I had a comment back.
I got a question.
I want that guitar.
Piss me off.
Do you believe that there was, before Adam and Eve, there were other humans or whatever?
No.
Or do you believe they were both?
Before Adam and Eve, those people, it weren't just two. It was a bunch of them.
Mm-hmm.
There were nothing else before that. There was people existence right. In a different realm. We existed in another realm.
What you mean? You talking about spiritual?
In another realm.
Okay.
Right. Not this physical realm. What they call this? Is this the fourth or the third dimension?
Fourth dimension, I think.
Well, read a book of Job. It says one that the sons of the morning.
There's one in the.
There was people on the earth at the same time Adam and Eve was on the earth.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, because Cain went out and got a wife.
Right, and this is what I'm trying. This is what I'm trying to get at. They're trying to say. Historians are trying to say that it was this woman named Lilith.
Oh God.
It was this woman named Lilith, and she was rebellious.
Yeah. That's actually a Freemason doctrine. That's what the Freemasons teach. Yeah, years ago, we had that Freemason magazine printed by the Freemasons. It's a monthly magazine, and they had the whole doctrine broke down, and they say Lilith. And they say she was mentioned in Isaiah 34. But Isaiah 34 is talking about Esau. It ain't got nothing to do with no Lilith. This is madness. don't pay heed to that shit. That's what you call one of those cunningly devised fables.
Yeah, yeah. Here you go. This is there's a reason why he put the scripture in here.
So when Cain went out to get a wife, who were the people that he was messing with?
It
could have been a Moab.
In the beginning, you had three different types of humans. You had the sons of man, originally. I'm talking about before the flood. You had the regular men. You had the sons of the wicked. Then you had the sons of God.
Right.
Okay, that was the three different classifications of men. So the sons of the just regular men would just be the regular humans, if you want to call them that. There's everything before the flood is kind of different anyway. But then you had the sons of God. That's who we Adam.
Israelites.
Adam.
Before we even was named Israel, we were still a nation of people.
Right. They called sons of. Tell you in the book of Luke, they called Adam the son of God in the book of Luke.
Mm-hmm. So when Genesis it said that he made man control every beast or whatever, he was pretty much talking about Adam, not the other people,
It's only Israel is in harmony with nature.
Right.
You know, all the mother nations cut all the trees down. By law, we use certain trees.
Right.
But they just chopping every fucking thing down.
Just
to put a parking lot there. No, I got Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes 12 and 12. And further by thee, my son, be admonished of making many books.
Making
like he was trying to tell you about
that's that Freemason doctrine.
Mm-hmm. There is no end.
And then they'll also say that the Eve was raped by the serpent, and that's where Cain came from. Because she'll try to say, when it says, I got a son begot by the Lord, that Lord was actually talking about the devil, and Cain was actually the part of the fruit was Satan fucking Eve. And it's just madness, you know what I'm saying? Right.
And much study is a weariness of the flesh. Because all that reading all them books, man, will actually fuck your head up.
It's good to read books, but...
Right, but you got to get this is foundation first.
What's that? Well, the Isaiah says, none shall want her mates.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, because the Bible don't...
That's Isaiah 34. I was just talking about 34.
Right, you sure was.
My friend, I was debating with my friend. He was talking about the whole Noah situation. He said that, because in the scriptures it says that the Lord regretted making humanity. And he said, if he regretted making humanity, how come he just couldn't, how come he destroyed everybody else but kept Noah when he could have just destroyed everyone else and just start all over from the beginning?
Start all over though.
Yeah, but he said with Noah and them, they still had sin also. They still was able to sin also.
Yeah, but Noah was a righteous man.
There was prophecies that had to have been fulfilled too.
Right.
So. Of course, Noah's family would have got
it. Right, and it was for prophecy's sake.
Here you go, Aaron. This is on you right here. This is Revelation 9 and 15.
Oh, that tells you about the... Oh, yeah.
And the four angels were loose, which were prepared for an hour and a day and a month and a year for to slay the third part of men. Remember he was telling you there's three categories of men before the fall?
Right, right.
The sons of the Most High, this nation, the sons of the men, which are the other nations, and the sons of the wicked, the third part of men.
One minute.
Wicked. That's the so-called the wicked, you know.
Right, right. 1 minute wicked,
so-called white man.
Right.
Yeah, that was Cain's mark. Where the Most High marked him.
Right.
Took his color from him. So that way everybody knew, like, okay, yeah, that's him.
That's
him.
He didn't put an X on his head.
Because he said he was fleeing from people. So he was fleeing from man and the wicked?
Right, right. Because being Adam and Eve being the only Adam, Eve, Cain, and Abel. Right, they make it seem like there was only four.
Right.
That cussed that up because he was worrying about the mother nations.
Now, where did you get this from? Is that in the original Hebrew Bible? Huh?
That's actually in Genesis where he says he was worrying about if people see me, they'll kill me.
That's not what Cain said. I was talking
that's
about the
Cain
whole
said.
Divide of other different people, like you said.
Hey, go ahead and take this one. Cut that one off.
I'm good. My arm.
And then he said the wicked. I said, they didn't say that in the scripture.
You like, cut that one off.
Oh, you mean like the three categories of people?
Yeah.
If you do your research, like,
well, he just
now
read
that
it,
is deep, deep research you got to do right
plus
there.
Plus, he just read it in Revelation 9. It tells you. Well, it tells you in Revelation. I mean, excuse me, Genesis. It tells you that you had Cain. He was wicked.